Turning now to sports, Megan's in for Ryan, and the trade deadline has come and gone. The Hawks weren't able to pull off that big deal that many fans were.
Tonight, the parents of a Southwest Suburban High School basketball player say she was bullied so severely at practice she was injured.
And she played with the team.
All right, Mike, thank you.
Well, for drivers, it is nerve-wracking. We're talking about how much gas prices have jumped in just days.
Yeah, we checked GasBuddy.com tonight. Are you one of the millions of people who use Yelp? It is one of the country's most popular websites, featuring listings and reviews of everything from restaurants and local businesses to doctors.
But are those reviews trustworthy? Tonight, two investigator Pam Zekman reports on controversy over the company's alleged sales techniques.
Kate, they do show that company and then put in a password, so they make it a bit difficult.
Interesting.
So what is Yelp, or what can the businesses that are being reviewed by Yelp, what can they do?
Well, what...
Okay, that's very interesting.
Fascinating. Thanks, fam. Witnesses say he never said a word, just started shooting. Tonight, what may have caused an Ohio teenager to open fire inside a high school today?
Well, as you probably know, artificial color can make food prettier or more fun to eat, but now there's some concern that some added color can cause problems in children. In fact, some companies in Europe have stopped using them.
But in tonight's Health Watch, Mary Kay Kleiss shows us these dyes are used here in everything from cereal to crackers to toothpaste. The FDA says it does not believe artificial food dyes cause hyperactivity in children in the general population, but it admits dyes might exacerbate problems in susceptible children diagnosed with ADHD because they may have a unique intolerance to them. The FDA is now reassessing safety studies relating to food dyes. You can see the full statement on our website, cbschicago.com. Let's hope. Talking about the forecast, we had plenty of sunshine today, but it was a bit on the windy and cold side for sure.
It was indeed. And Steve.
Okay, will do. Thank you, Steve.
The Bulls All-Stars get back to business, prepared to put the heat on Miami in the second. Time now for sports. Megan's in for Ryan. The Blackhawks blockbuster trade so many fans were hoping for didn't exactly happen at the trade deadline today, did it, Meg?
No, it did not. Very anticlimactic. Mm-hmm. I guess they have to have faith in the guys. The driver of the truck is at the hospital, but he is resting okay. This is the race that just will not end, and we are hearing now, even if they got this back up and running, there's a chance it might rain again tonight. So who knows?
They could call it, though, with 40 laps left, couldn't they?
They could, but why do you guys want to get it in? Why? It could go to Tuesday, the race that just keeps on going and going.
After that explosion, you sort of say, maybe we should cut it off.
Yeah, I think so.
Thank God the driver's okay.
Why don't you tell them, Meg?
Yeah, right. Okay, thanks.
Thank you, man. The popular fitness or dance video games may get the kids off the couch, but do they give them a workout? What we found out next. The owners of 13 classic cinemas have a new policy when it comes to R-rated movies. Parents can no longer bring children under six.
A new study in the journal Pediatrics tracked nearly 80 children to see if the games would help them meet their daily exercise requirements. Researchers found there was no evidence children playing those games were more active than those playing stationary games, but it sure is funny watching them dance.
It is, and I would have thought that. I would have thought they would have gotten some. Steve is back with your wake-up weather.
That will be later in the day.
All right.
Thank you, Steve.
That's it for CBS 2 News at 10. Join us again at 4:30 a.m. for the CBS 2 Morning News. David Letterman's up next with actor Ed Helms. I'm Rob Johnson.
I'm Kate Sullivan. For Steve Baskerville and Megan Mulkey, have a great night.